good day, evening. It's winter time, you don't know. So yeah, a fresh upload with two cameras. As you might have seen, a couple of Super Socos and a couple of Rio uploads still coming. Believe me, I have more. So we all see footage in the beautiful sunshine, which is a little bit older. We're middle in the COVID lockdown. But don't worry, I have an essential job, so I need to go to work every single day. I'm also riding with my clear visor. I've decided to give it a go. Originally I wanted to ride to the Lewis, the store, because the pinlock visors aren't that cheap. The pinlock inlays, whatever you want to call them. I wanted to get an inlay so I could switch my clear visor and my tinted visor without having to worry about the pinlock. But the pinlocks were not that cheap and the shipping fee is the same, no matter whether it's a box or an envelope. And it could easily fit an envelope. And I was thinking, yeah, I'm not gonna pay, I think it's $7.99 or whatever, for an envelope. So I might as well drive there. And then lockdown happened. And I decided, fuck it. I might as well just put my pinlock in my clear visor and only use my clear visor until I can use my tinted visor again. Because the tinted visor of the Nishua helmet is way too dark for this darkness. This is already too dark for the camera, let's be honest. So I hope this camera does better in the dark. Although the switch will be even more irritating if they have different light sensibilities.
Quickly in between. It's moving inside. So it might be dead. No idea yet. Damn it. It's also making noise already for some time, but this is new, the lens.
Yeah, roughly 10 days and my video a day stream begins. I have a rough idea what I'm gonna upload. Due to the type of vlogs I make and whatever, and due to the fact that I'm working most days and what not more, I don't have 3 days. I don't have the realistic option to do a daily vlog for the daily video. Some people do. Fayamira has done or is doing the Christmas, the Vlogmas, so a vlog a day, literally filming. I think he also filmed most of it every single day. So mad respect for that. I'm not. You're gonna see some other footage, I'm sorry. Probably some Rios and Super Soco. I got one video which is a bobber slash chopper that I did a quick ride on, but with all the lockdown stuff that didn't go as planned, so I still have that footage left. It's roughly 9 months old now, so time to upload it. I got a special video that I already talked about, and I think I'm gonna do a Alex riding with Alex rides video with the special moment in it, and then do a me mashup of the moment as I have done before with the Honda. Some of the older people might remember that. So there's 2 videos already. It can go quickly. I got a special helmet video that I want to do. Hopefully I can get everything round for that. Bit time schedule-y, but I think I can do. I want to do a video about a specific train track. Now you might think, train track? Yeah, don't worry. Upcoming Wednesday is a review video, and then that shows the train track. And believe it or not, the Thursday after that, I'm gonna record the video about that. Hopefully there's something to record, but I got an idea. So that makes 7 out of 10 already. And then I probably will upload some random stuff and I film some stuff, of course. Yeah, I'm not quite sure if I begin on the 24th or the 25th, so actually Christmas Day or the Christmas night. Not fully sure on that yet. Ah, oh, but man, I'm looking forward to it. It's a little bit stressy, but I'm looking forward to it. Of course, stressy in the sense of I need to do a lot of editing in my very few free days to get everything ready. But it is fun, especially if you have accomplished it, if you have ended it, if you had success. It always is a good moment. I also have a video recorded. I'm not fully sure what I will do with it. Something happened to this bike and it got me irritated, and I talked about it with different people. And when I fixed the problem, I decided, you know what, F it, I'm gonna take the camera with me. Imagine if life gives you lemons, let's make lemonade. And that's kind of what I did. I filmed the whole shebang. So used to coughing in my hands that I opened my visor just to cough in my glove. But yeah, maybe I will edit and upload that as well. I think it is worth it. Even though it's very, very short and dirty probably, but obviously there's also something planned for this bike, because 2020 was not the year most people wanted it to be. It started off actually quite alright. We had the Motorcycle Expo, where the whole DMC got together, or at least a big part of the DMC. Now, I wasn't the most obviously one there, because I'm a little bit socially awkward, a little bit of an introvert. But I enjoyed myself. I spoke to different people, met some people for the first time, met some people for the second or third time. And I think that was organized mainly by Motor Test TV and Pomp It Live. So if you're Dutch, go check those channels out. Considering how big they are, you probably already have, but you know. Then we also had the Kawasaki days in Apeldoorn, which I think was the brain idea for Motor Test TV, so again, shout out to him. That was also an awesome, awesome day. And then lockdown kind of happened, and a lot of things and ideas we had with the DMC, Dutch Motor Vloggers Collective, burned out. I think we can do a lot more in the upcoming years. I think we have a big and strong group. Then again, I did still meet Adventure Boys a couple of times. I met Alex Wright a couple of times, even when he was still Nolting Rides. So, you know, yeah, we did some meetups here and there. Chefman did his first meetup, which was awesome. We had big rideouts, we had small rideouts. So yeah, a lot of good thing, but not what we really anticipated. I really, really enjoyed the Mesh Dirt Track. I really enjoyed the Rio, which I both had for a week, thanks to Motomundo, which is the Dutch dealership, or the dealership for the whole Benelux. So Belgium, Netherlands, Luxembourg. I had the Super Sogo, totally unexpected for a whole week, also awesome. And I definitely want to do more of those whole week reviews next year. X-Ride is definitely up there for the 21 year, for next year. Back to the DMC, I also got into the Belgium Discord for motor vloggers, which is also a very nice and kind group. If Corona allows it, we might go into Belgium next year a couple of times. CDA 41 or 441 is a Belgian vlogger who joined my ride here in the Netherlands, which was awesome, so I have to return the favor someday. And yes, I did invest some time into clothing design. Not the only one. Max B, a Dutch motor vlog, already has sometime a clothing line. Of course, Full Slick, which is on a Moto Expo. And now Suduzu also has a clothing line. Motoholic, I think it's pronounced correctly. I'll also drop that link down below. And he got helped out with, for example, Dutch Wasp and Kiwiet. Again, via Miro, who is doing the Vlogmas. He has been meeting up with a couple of guys. The way he's doing the Vlogmas, I have massive respect for that as well. I mean, considering all the positive things we did in such a negative year, I'm really looking forward to 21. I got some mad ideas of my own. Some will probably never happen. Some hopefully will. I'm still learning Instagram. I think my biggest learning curve I can still make is social media. Instagram, Facebook, Twitter. I know some people even use TikTok. Which, by the way, downside of Discord, Spicy Discord has some really funny but weird people on there. And I can say that because I'm one of them. For anyone from Spicy's Discord, hell yeah for the pineapple on pizza. You guys rock. But thanks to them, I kind of got TikTok on my phone. I'm not yet using it, but I do share TikToks from time to time there. But yeah, I definitely blame Spicy's Discord for the fact that I have TikTok on my phone now. Any things that I actually have targets for next year? 1,500 subscribers would be a good target, but I'm not that far away anymore. So if I can get a good push through my daily uploads, I might reach the 1,500 this year, so I can focus for the 2k next year. Which honestly, if you would tell me somewhere in 2019 that I could hit 2k in 21, I would declare you insane. But ever since I hit the 1k, and especially since I got monetized, the channel is growing faster. And I think that's YouTube doing. And I do hope the secondary camera helps to improve quality as well. But yeah, man, it is. I don't know why I'm doing like a ending year vlog now. We still got 2 weeks to go or whatever, but I'm doing it now! Mainly because I also want to update you about the daily upload styles. What can you expect? If I can get everything I want to edit out of the way and I have time left, I might do the Super Soco review, because that one is burning a hole in my hand. For the Rio Marathon 125cc Pro, I already done a written review, which you can find on startersmotor.nl. Maybe by now, maybe not. That one is in Dutch. I will do a video review, of course in English as well, but it will be January for sure. I just don't know where to get the time from. Mainly because all my audio for this video has been effed up. So I do need to do a voiceover, and then I want to do it properly. I want, like, writing down just the main keywords, and I'm doing the voiceover based on that. Maybe do 2 and 3 voiceovers to see which one flows better. So that becomes from a project which is already really, really big in normal, because you have a week of footage that you can use for your reviews. So those weekly reviews are already really, really big. And then to add the whole multi-layer voiceover, man, I'm gonna get my ass kicked on that one. But it is what it is. I want to do what I want to do. I think this is where I'm gonna end the video. This is gonna be a long one again. Let me know what are your plans for next year. Anyone of you actually going to a motorcycle expo next year? Oh yeah, I also need to record part 1 of a special video, because 2021 will begin fresh.